Hi everyone and welcome to today's video. Sharing is something that lies very close to my heart and have benefited me a lot throughout my life actually, and especially when it comes to my health and also healing. I know that sharing issues related to pelvic floor dysfunction can be very, very challenging. And many women that I speak to actually don't share, even with their husbands, what they are going through. So it might be that they share it only with their doctor or physiotherapist. But in this video, I'm gonna talk about sharing, not in just telling someone something to get like a diagnosis or to get help, but what actually happens in our brains and hearts when we share open and honestly to someone who can truly listen and understand. I am also not going to talk about sharing in the sense of some kind of therapy or psychologist listening to you and sort of analyzing your situation. It's not that type of sharing that I am going to talk about in this video. Instead, I wanna talk about what I found some studies showing on peer-to-peer sharing. So it's a human being connection. It's from human to human. It's not that you have some kind of degree. You're not gonna help me. You're not an expert and I'm telling you something, but it is just sharing honest, raw, openly what you are going through. And I think it's really, really important, especially regarding women's health issues, that we start to share about this, because nothing will happen, nothing will change if we don't start to speak our truth and what we are going through. And you don't have to start a YouTube channel like me and talk about it so openly, but for your health benefits, it will help a lot if you share, at least with other women in the same situation. And in the end of this video, I'm gonna give some examples of how you can share. Super easy and quick, and it will be a relief for your own health benefits and your nervous system, your emotions, that I speak a lot about, is such important components to healing on this channel. Just a quick background, my own like relationship with sharing. It's always been very easy for me to share, which helps a lot, of course. I know many women I speak to, you know, they feel so much resistance in sharing anything that they are going through, and I completely respect that. It's very, very different where you are in that sort of path. So actually, I was with a friend who went to a 12-step program meeting when I was in my 20s. And I was just blown away in the way that people shared their experience, and so openly and raw. And they, you know, they've been through so much shit, actually. It's like I was just so humbled after that meeting to understand what people are going through, and also the power of sharing in that circle where everybody else except the one who spoke just sat quietly and listened, and everybody just said, you know, thank you afterwards, and then the next person spoke only from their own, not commenting a lot on everybody else. If they commented on something another person said, that would be more like what happened inside of them when another person spoke about something else. So it was such a respectful way to share and express and communicate with each other as human beings. So I think it's so, so powerful. And those types of meetings actually make people, you know, not to drink alcohol or not to smoke cigarettes. It's so powerful, and they really need it as their medicine. Otherwise, they would fall back into their addiction again. To share in this way, it's like you are opening up a hole somewhere in your body, just letting some pressure out. And that pressure, if you don't let it out, it will probably have some kind of effect either on your brain, nervous system, fascia, or mentally somehow. And after having that experience in the 12-step program, I actually started to implement it myself when I was teaching yoga or having coaching sessions or working with leadership in different groups and so on. And I've seen time and again how powerful it is to share openly from the heart. So I really would like to encourage you to start to share somehow and have that as a preferably daily practice, but it could also be on a weekly basis at least to relieve some of the pressure that we carry inside and just let go of that and give it to the universe, and the universe will take care of it beautifully. So before we go into the next part where I talk a bit more about how to actually share, I just want to say that there are now scientific studies that shows that we are activating the brain and the nervous system when we share on an equal level from peer to peer with each other as human beings. And I'm going to link to a few of the studies below. So I'm not going to talk more about the studies, but I think it's so powerful that more and more, both the healthcare system and in other ways, people are using sharing as a health tool and to support the well-being in human beings' lives. Okay, so different ways to share, especially for women with pelvic floor dysfunctions. The first one is definitely one that most of you already know, that there are a lot of different Facebook groups around this. And I think especially women probably is better doing this than men, which is amazing because we really need to make stronger connections being women in this world and how to handle this kind of experience. One thing though with the Facebook communities and groups is that many women with pelvic floor dysfunctions are not always feeling that well mentally, and the tendency in some groups I experience at least is that the women in those groups kind of almost just drag each other down instead of lifting each other up. So I would just be very careful if you are in any groups that you feel almost more depressed after you've been looking around what they post and all the comments. I would recommend you to leave that group and really search for groups where there is a supportive community. And we have created such a Facebook group, so I'm going to link to that below. At least you can join that and see what you feel about that. Another way to share, of course, is with your partner or friends and family. So you don't have to share with all of them, of course. If you feel you can, please do, because I really think it would help everyone so much if more people started to understand what we go through as women. But you don't have to be an activist in this. It's more than enough if you pick one person that you decide you want to share this journey with. And if you do have someone around you that you can share with, I would just encourage you not to let that type of sharing become a discussion around anything or, you know, getting into nitty-gritty details and staying there and being like very negative and not feeling good in that conversation. So what you could actually do is asking this person, could I just share something and you just listen? You don't have to say anything. I just want you to listen. And then you just kind of let that pressure out. And you can talk about anything that is kind of wearing you down. So it could be definitely about any symptoms, but also, you know, things that just make you feel sad or depressed or angry. We just want to let go of that pressure. And we could actually be sharing with anyone, another human being will suffice. It doesn't have to be anyone in particular, just someone there in front of us or on the phone or anywhere will have that effect on the brain and the nervous system. So that's definitely a way you can do it. Other ways to share is, of course, journaling, and you can just keep that to yourself. You can keep it as a diary so you can go back and read. You can also just write anything that you are carrying, and then once you've written it, you burn it so that you really can feel you're letting go of it and it's not yours to carry anymore. It's like a symbol for the universe to actually show that you're gonna burn this one. Another way to share is also to do audio messages to yourself. If you don't like writing, you can always do audio messages and just, you know, blah, blah, blah. Just let it out. You just talk about whatever that your system is carrying around, and you only stop when you feel a bit lighter. Or, you know, sometimes maybe you want to cry it out, and just so you cry and cry and talk, and, you know, it doesn't really matter what you say as long as the intention is to let go of things that you are carrying around emotionally that will affect your nervous system and fascia. So if we carry around emotions, they will actually stick in our fascia as adhesions and become frozen fascia. And we really want to work on healing fascia in every cell of the body when we are working with pelvic floor dysfunction, because most pelvic floor dysfunctions stem from scar tissue and frozen fascia. And I talk more about that in other videos if you are curious. So that's all I had to say about sharing today, but I think this is such an interesting topic and really worth exploring. If you have any questions or comments, please do comment below this video and let me know how this goes for you.